Next we have is rapid sand filter. So the rate of filtration what we can achieve using this filter ranges between 3000 to 6000 liter per hour per meter square, whereas this rate of filtration in slow sand filter is between 100 to 200 liter per hour per meter square. So obviously it is much higher in rapid sand filter, that's why it is used for the public supplies. Apart from that, in this case, in rapid sand filter, we use a sand bed of around 60 to 90 centimeter, and the height of water above this will be somewhere around 1 to 1.2 meter, and the effective size of particle, that is D10, here it is greater than that was in slow sand filter. So here it is between 0.35 to 0.55 mm, and the coefficient of uniformity, that is D60 by D10, is taken between 1.3 to 1.7. So this sand bed is between 60 to 90 centimeter, and below this there will be a gravel bed. So this gravel is used to distribute the wash water, I mean the water which is coming from and which is cleaned from the top, it will be distributed on this sand, on this gravel bed, and below this there will be pipes, laterals, manifold, main pipes, etc. So that will carry the filtered water. Apart from that, how do we use, I mean, what is the treatment process? So in this process we apply the water from coagulation sedimentation tank. So the first water is sedimented with the help of some coagulant, and then we use it in rapid sand filter. So if water, I mean, if even if some turbidity is there in water, so that is already removed from the coagulation sedimentation tank. And area of filter, typical area what we use here is between 10 to 80 meter square, that is the filter area for one unit, whereas in case of slow sand filter, this filter area is between 100 to 2000 meter square. So obviously for slow sand filter, required area is also very high, so space requirement will be more. Now there is one equation which is used to find out the number of filters, that is given by Morel and Wallace. And it is n is equal to 1.22 under root q, where n is the number of filter units and q is the flow in million liters per day. If 3 MLD is the flow, then we will take q is equal to 3 that way. But this formula, if only design is considered, then we go for it. Otherwise in question, if you have been given total area and the area of one unit, then you can simply find out n by dividing the total area with area of one unit. So if only flow is mentioned and nothing about area of one unit is mentioned, then only go for this formula. Now for the working of the filter, working is similar. We apply the water up to a depth of 1 to 1.2 meter, then it gets filtered with the mechanisms we have already seen initially. And after the head loss increases a lot, I mean if the head loss exceeds, then we have to go for, we can say, cleaning of filter. And this cleaning of filter is done using backwashing here. So unlike the slow sand filter, here we use backwashing. In slow sand filter, how are we doing the cleaning? We were removing this top 1.5 to 3 centimeter of sand layer, and then we were doing the cleaning simply by scrubbing and cleaning with water. But in this case, because the particle size is more, what happens? The impurities penetrate further downward, and we have to clean these impurities which are there somewhere in the middle of the filter also. So these impurities can be cleaned properly if we use the technique of backwashing. So in backwashing, what is done? The highly, I mean, the water with high pressure, pressured water, and compressed air is applied from the below or from the bottom. So what does it do? So let's say we have this filter bed. So from here, that is the bottom of this filter, air, if compressed air is applied, then compressed air and highly pressured water is applied from this below the filter, then what happens? These sand particles, they get agitated and some voids are created. I mean, the space between them increases. So their depth, let's say initially it was D, then it increases by 50%. So initially the sand was there up to only this depth D. Then after this application of backwater, it will be D plus D by 2, that is 1.5 D. So 50% increase in depth happens due to this backwashing, and all the impurities, this water will come out from here and then it is removed from the suitable arrangement. Backwater troughs are provided for that. So that way these filters are cleaned, and after that we can again use these filters. So for some times from, we will start to apply the raw water again from the top, but we do not use this water for some time until this layer of impurities form, so that they can help in further cleaning. So around 15 minutes are required for complete backwashing process. Backwashing plus further this, we apply the water from the top also, this is included in the 15 minutes. After this, and after backwashing, this backwashing is required in 24 to 48 hours. That is very frequently we have to do this backwashing, and the amount of water which is required, it is between 2 to 5% of total water that is getting filtered. So that amount is also very high. So this water is not wasted, it again comes as raw, it again comes as raw water, and it again goes in the treatment plant to get filtered. And the pressure which is used for backwashing is 40 kN per meter square. So equivalently, if you want to convert into the height, P is equal to gamma H. So let's say unit weight is 10 of water, then H will be equal to 4 meter. So that is equivalent to 4 meter of water head. So that much pressure is needed for this backwashing. Now let's see the various filter problems. So first we can talk about this air binding. So what happens as this cleaning process goes on, as the water gets cleaned, again this head loss will be taking place with time. So let's say initially the water level was here and water level was here on the downstream. So this head loss will keep on increasing. This will go here and further here. And why this head loss is happening? First of all, this head loss is happening because as the water is flowing downward, it is facing some resistance from sand particles. So at one point, what happens? This head loss increases so much that, let's say, static head, if we are measuring from here, if this is our datum, then static head is up to this height, this is your static head, and some head loss will be taking place. So this head loss becomes greater than this static head. Let's say this static head is H, then head loss becomes greater than static head. What is your static head here? It is equal to H. In that case, negative pressure inside filter. So what happens due to this negative pressure? So negative pressure is there. So on the top, there is positive pressure. On the on somewhere here we are getting negative pressure. So because of this high pressure difference, the water is sucked rather than getting filtered. So no filtering will be taking place if the water is getting sucked, and then the filter will not work efficiently. Other than that, if this negative pressure is there, so we require some particular amount of pressure so that this air or oxygen which is there in water, it remains dissolved. But if this pressure reduces so much, then this oxygen or air which is dissolved in water, it will start to come out. It will be coming out, and so this air, this water will be releasing air, and this air will get, these bubbles which are air bubbles, they will surround these sand particles, and we will face the problem of it is called as air binding. So because of this, this filter will not work efficiently, and if we are doing backwashing also, then because of these bubbles, the water which is this backwashing water, it is not distributed properly, and because of that, backwashing is not proper. So these are the troubles we may face due to this air binding, and there are several other causes also for air binding. So apart from this negative head, if temperature rises, temperature goes up, so the solubility of oxygen in water decreases with increase in temperature. So if temperature is more, then solubility will be less, so this oxygen will be released, and we'll face the problem of air binding and associated other problems with it. Other than that, if algae is there in this filter, so algae also releases oxygen, so because of that also this problem of air binding can take place. And other than that, these are the associated issue with air binding. So next problem which can happen in filter is formation of mud balls. So in this problem, what happens? Some mud gets accumulated from atmosphere on the filter surface, and this mud will stick to the sand particles. And later, if this mud is not removed in backwashing, then what happens? It increases in size, and because these voids are not very small, so it can go inside also. So it goes down inside, and further it gets stuck to other particles or other impurities, and further it can even more sink. So below gravel is there, so it can reach up to the gravel layer and increase in size. So what happens now when you try to do the backwashing? So it causes turbulence if these mud balls are created and these are present here. So because of this, proper distribution of water will not happen, and it will cause turbulence, and the sand particles which are there just above these mud balls, they will not be cleaned properly, and further accumulation of mud will happen. So if once this mud ball has started accumulating, so they increase in size, further accumulation will happen, and totally the working of this filter will be hampered. So proper care has to be taken to remove these mud balls. After mud balls, next filter trouble is cracking of sand or cracking of filters. So what happens? These sand which is there on the top layer, it is of very fine size. So because of that, it shrinks. So because of this shrink on these, mostly it happens between there is this junction of sand and wall. At this part it will shrink, so there will be a crack formation between the wall and these sand particles. And further, it can, as we are increasing the head, as we put the water, so this head goes up and down. So because of that also, further these cracks can increase. And after these cracks have increased, so rather than the water will be filtered, these impurities can simply enter through these cracks. So these impurities will get down and the filter will not be working properly. So that is your cracking of filter. That these are the filter troubles that are faced in rapid sand filter. And if you are talking about the removal capacity, so 80 to 90% of bacteria is removed in rapid sand filter. So in slow sand filter we saw it is between 98 to 99%, so it was more in slow sand filter. But the water what is obtained from rapid sand filter, it always goes for disinfection, and there all these bacteria is removed. So this 80 to 90% bacteria removal is not a problem from that point of view. And so for turbidity, they can remove the turbidity and bring it down up to 35 to 40 milligram per liter. So they are little better than slow sand filter, but here turbidity is not an issue because the water which is introduced to rapid sand filter, it comes from the coagulation sedimentation tank. So already the turbidity is removed. Apart from that, they are very good in or very good for color removal. So that is about the rapid sand filters. Next, we will see some problems which have come in GATE. If you have any queries, please ask. If you like the video, please subscribe the channel and check out the other videos as well. Thank you.